Put on grease, press in the cups. That's all you have to do. Then cut off the fork column. Make sure you measure twice, cut once. Now Tommasini is going to show here why he does not recommend using a campagnolo headset tool on this. You will notice that the headset has about a 1.4 millimeter area that goes into the head tube. That is all that you will need to grind out of there. You don't need to grind anymore. Now if you check a campagnolo tool, you will see that there is much more area there than 1.4 millimeters, or 1.4 centimeters, I'm sorry. As such, the campagnolo tool is going to take a lot of metal out of the head tube that does not need to be removed. Tommasini says, grease, press in the cups, leave it alone. It's ready to assemble. The campagnolo system is old. There it is, the magic elixir, grease.
Okay.
Okay.
Capito?
Now all that has to be done is just press them in.
Okay. Okay. No lavoro qua. Niente.
No more work.
Fare niente. Perfetto.
Leave the frame alone, it's ready. Again, these are the Fraccaro team bikes. Tommasini and the boys are assembling them, and you will see how easily they're put together. Other than headset press tools and a few minor wrenches, that's it. Nothing special has been done to these frames. These frames are exactly as we receive them in America. Notice how easily the headset is pressed in. Note the easy assembly of the bottom bracket. Only limited tools need be used. Frame very similar to this was used to win the Giro della Regione in Italy last year, and also Chan McCrae used a little competizione to win the U.S. National Road Race Championships in 1992. Nothing too sophisticated, just good quality and precision. Cantando poi fa un po' prendere in Cigaretto riders have now received their bikes, including the two racers that we saw earlier in the video. They're getting prepared to go out on one of their early morning training rides. We will go along with them. Off we go onto the outskirts of a small Italian city. Now we're in the countryside. Again, this is a training ride.
L'ho vista uscire mano nella mano con quell'africano che non parla neanche bene l'italiano, ma si vede che si fa capire bene quando vuole. Tutte le sere mi accompagna a casa una diversa. Chissà che...
Note the support.
Per me è la macchina che già che conta.
And this is where we leave them. Notice they'll say goodbye. Tommasini's family and employees now say goodbye in their own special way. This finishes our tour of the Tommasini factory. We hope this has answered any questions you may have. If not, please contact us. And now, on to Roval aerodynamic wheels.
We're going to do step one, and that would be rim orientation. You have to set the rim so that the spoke holes are offset. These are two down, one up, two down, and one up.
We use the valve hole as a starting guide. We'll bring that around over here, grab a nipple, insert it into the nut driver and begin. And at this point, you just need to thread them on. Just a few threads so that it'll grab the nip, the spoke, and go all the way around. And remember that they're offset two and one and two and one, so you do two together. Skip a hole and you go to the next. Here you have the finished rim with the drive side spokes all installed, and you notice that they are in pairs, skip, and pairs and skip. Then to orient the hub, you do that the same way. You're going to place the freewheel side first, and you can use any starting point. The way to do that is to grab pairs, these two, and you go straight across to the hub, and you see where they line up that way. Find this equivalent over here, goes in and twist. And from that point you cross over, twist, straight across, twist, in and twist. There's the finish wheel. Next step is to begin back again at the spoke hole here and to just thread them in until the last thread is just barely visible. And you go all the way around the wheel that way. Okay, now that we've tensioned the bottom flange equally, we begin to insert the upper flange radial spokes one by one, just like you did with the ones down below. The last two here. There. And here. is simply you just go straight into the flange, up, the left hand, and twist. Now you have the wheel completely laced. It's loose tension. And to add the tension now, we go over to the truing stand. So here we go to the truing stand. The wheel locked and centered. The next step is to apply some Loctite compound to the threads. Next step will be tensioning this right side so we can get the dish over to this side. So we're going to work on the right side spokes. At this point, we've begun to add tension, and the wheel is laterally true, reasonably true, and reasonably round. The next point, next start step from here is to dish the wheel properly. And we've just about got that done. We still need about another 2 millimeters. So I'm going to reduce the tension on the left side by a quarter of a turn, and then add the tension to the right side by a quarter of a turn. And we're going to go. Once you've gotten some good tension onto the wheel, there's some important things to check. One of those is the angle that the spoke exits the rim. A lot of times they go out and then out toward the flange. You want to put a thumb here near the rim and apply pressure this way in the direction of the flange. This reduces some of the stress. The spoke. The other area to check is to make sure that the head of the nipple is seated properly into the flange. As you add tension, they sometimes twist. You see these are all seated properly, and the same for the radial side. And finally, as you're adding tension, it's good to continually stress the spokes. That is to make sure that they're not twisted and that they're seated properly. You can grab pairs and just squeeze this way, and sometimes you can hear a little pinging noise. That's a sign of properly seating, but also note that when they do that, they also tend to lose a little tension. You do the right side, the left side also, grabbing them that way. After it's all been stressed, it's good to check the true once more to see how the stressing has affected the spokes, and this one still remains true. It's dished, it's round, so here you have a finished wheel. Okay, I'm going to show how to remove this new SAB hub. Quite easy. Here we have a 17 millimeter wrench and a 5 millimeter Allen wrench, and you just, that's unlocked. At that point, you can remove the left side cone. It comes off completely, and then out comes the axle. So here you have the axle itself, its alloy. There are no adjustable parts to the right side. All the adjustments are done to this left. And there you see the bearings. They're completely sealed cartridge type bearings. They're inserted with a press fit. Okay, here's the axle. That goes into the freewheel side. Hold it in place. And then the left side cone goes on. This is done just by hand. You'll feel it until it just touches the bottom. There. Back it off a little and do it again just so it touches the bottom. There. Then you hold it in place with the wrench. And then you lock it with the 5 millimeter Allen wrench. To lock it. We'll be right back.
Quattro Assi strata frames will be built out of Reynolds 731 oversized tubing. This tubing is internally ribbed in three main tubes and is extremely strong and lightweight. Mitering is very important. Without proper mitering, you cannot get a really proper fit when the tubes go together. So much care must be given to this. Frame building is very important. To measure twice, cut once. Less mistakes are made that way. Strata frames are built with Reynolds lugs, bottom bracket shelf, fork crown, and brake bridge. As you can see, the three steps are very important to come up with a really nicely finished lug set. Lots of time, energy, and precision is needed to convert these relatively rough lugs into really nicely finished ones.
Thank you.
lug sets also need lots of work, as you can see from these examples. This is the first as they come out of the box, the second as a certain amount of workmanship, and third when it's finished. Instead of using the ordinary cast seat stay caps, which are somewhat heavy, Quattro Assi uses machining, brazing, and hand filing to make his own, which is of course much lighter, as you will see. First, a very precise cut must be made so that this can be developed. Is made. Care must be taken to make sure that everything is prepared properly for the brazing of the plate over the chains or the seat stays. An ordinary piece of metal is used for this.
Dammeli se puoi. È una notte falsa, troppo queste le che non sa, dopo solitari cosa fai? Tu che parli spesso dentro il cuore con chi sei, riparlami se vuoi e ascoltami se puoi.
Rough edges are now ground off, and all excess weight goes along with it. The finished product will be a seat stay that is much lighter than the traditional with the cap on it, with the cast cap. It takes a little more time, but it's worth it. Finished seat stay, done to perfection. The frame is now prepared for tacking. This assembly must be done with extreme care. The assembled frame is then inserted into the bike machinery stand. Quality is thus assured. making sure the angles are correct. Again, measure twice, cut once, or in this case, measure twice and tack. The triangle is tacked, again the frame is measured, making sure that the angles are correct. If the angles are off by a little bit, of course they can be cold set at this time, as in this case. Taken at all points in the construction of these frames, and it is. Another example of how the frame is aligned and checked. Make sure that everything is straight, aligned, and ready to go before final brazing. This is done to each frame. Measuring for the seat stays. Again, measuring for the seat stays. As you can see, this isn't easy. It's time consuming. But it's best to do it right. Seat stays are now tacked to the frame, completing the whole triangle. Ready for brazing. But before that, one final check. making sure that everything is straight and precise. Alignment is important, especially when you're descending at about 50 miles an hour. Bike machinery table is used again to make sure the alignment is right on. Extreme care is given to this process because once it is brazed, it's a lot more difficult to correct. A skilled hand is a must. Overheating will destroy the tubes, make them brittle, cause cracking. Also be brazed on with extreme care. Attaching the brake bridge is also very important. If it is not done correctly, brakes will not work correctly. Again, at 50 miles an hour, this is important.
Svogliatamente non metti mai niente che possa attirare attenzione particolare, solo per farti guardare.
Sandblasting is also important because it prepares the frame for the final painting.